Welcome back. Tonight we are looking to the future with Langston University's outgoing president.
Her resignation came as a surprise to many, but she says it was a difficult, gradual decision. Morning anchor Anita Blanton has the interview you'll see only on 5.
Dr. Haysbert's tenure at Langston has been full of great accomplishments and challenges. She opened up to me as she's preparing to leave, and interestingly enough, there's a new concept for incoming freshmen that speaks volumes about how she came to that decision to say goodbye.
This site is a part of a dream realized. This place, the Student Success Center at Langston, was just one step of a 10-year strategic plan that in Dr. Haysbert's 6 years here is nearly complete.
And as I looked at what we had done, and there's never a, I guess, a best time to go, but I think those things led to where we are today.
It's a time when incoming freshmen are being taught a new concept that failure is not an option, from an outgoing president, the first female president of Langston, that knows a thing or two about weathering storms.
For the woman to be the man in charge, then I think that people are still coming to grips with that.
Her greatest challenge, she says, was simple: resistance to change.
You've got to be strong enough to know that this is the right thing to do at this time for the institution. We've all agreed upon it. Let's stay the course.
That she did, and even after she's gone, she wants the students here to do the same.
I want them to recognize that Langston is all that she's always been. It's an institution that has a strong legacy, and most importantly, it has a great future.
This is a family she says she'll always cherish.
Dr. Haysbert was asked once before, since she's been here, to return to Hampton University, where she spent 25 years. At that time, she said no. Now she's going back as the executive vice president. Anita Blanton, Eyewitness News 5.
Now, Langston will appoint an interim president for the spring semester, and then they'll start searching for Dr. Haysbert's replacement.